Dear students, today I am going to discuss your practical of paper 1, and that is from organic chemistry. So the heading is elemental analysis. So during this practical, you have to just analyze whether the given organic compound is having nitrogen, sulfur or halogen. So these three elements you can analyze from the given organic compound. And you know, since this is organic compound, there is always carbon and hydrogen. So oxygen may be present. That's why I put here oxygen in a bracket. So during this practical, or the purpose of this practical is to analyze nitrogen, sulfur, halogen, or all these three together. Now see, this practical you have to perform in two parts. First part is preparation of sodium extract. So this is very crucial part of this practical and very sensitive here. Now for this purpose, I have already shared one video. Hope you have seen that video. Now I am going to discuss the practical, the chemistry, actual chemistry behind this practical. Now see, for this practical, you need to take a fusion tube. This is a small, just glass tube, like test tube. You can see here, very small test tube, or we call it as a fusion tube. Now, in this fusion tube, you have to insert, you have to take a small piece of sodium metal. You know, handling of sodium metal is again very challenging. It is always kept in a paraffin oil because we have to cut off the air contact, because sodium is highly sensitive towards water, all of you know this, and it is reacting very violently with water to produce sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas with lot of heat. So this heat is sufficient to catch fire. Now see, to avoid accident, we must keep our sodium safe, or we must protect our sodium from water vapors even. So because of this, this is stored in a paraffin oil, and whenever it is required, we have to cut the required piece of sodium metal and dry it by using a filter paper, and then you introduce this into this fusion tube, right? So I have shown here. So when the sodium metal is introduced into this fusion tube, you need a burner, Bunsen burner. So you have to heat this fusion tube on this Bunsen burner, so the sodium metal melts. So once it is melt, you have to introduce equal quantity. Equal means approximately equal to the sodium metal of organic compound. Introduce here in this fusion tube. Once you take organic compound over the sodium metal, again you have to heat this fusion tube on this burner. Initially you must heat it very carefully, because you know the reaction is very violent. So after some time you can start heating strongly on this burner, and once it is converted to red hot. So after some time you can see it is converted to red hot state. So immediately you have to pour this red hot fusion tube along with fused organic compound with the sodium into this porcelain dish having approximately 10 ml distilled water. So what is your porcelain dish is having approximately 10 ml distilled water. So once you pour it, in fact you have to cover this porcelain dish with the help of wire gauze. So immediately as you pour this red hot fuse into this distilled water, you have to just keep immediately, you have to cover that fusion porcelain dish with a wire gauze. Otherwise some unreacted sodium may react with water to generate lot of heat, and there might be an explosion, or that sodium might eject as a missile. So to protect yourself you have to cover this porcelain dish with a wire gauze. Now, once you see that the unreacted sodium is now ceased, I mean, there is no reaction, you can hear the sound of that reaction. So once it is done, once the reaction is over, you can remove that cover and you have to break this fusion tube. It is already broken, but you have to still break, and you have to you have to remove whatever is fused inside this fusion tube must mix with this distilled water. So once it is done, you have to boil it. So once you have to boil it, because you can see if these elements are there, so particularly you will get certain compounds in very small amount. So you have to concentrate this water, this mixture, by just boiling. So you have to reduce its volume. You have to reduce the volume of distilled water, and after cooling, boiling and cooling, so you have to again filter this boiled solution by using this funnel. So whatever you get here, it should be a clear solution. This clear solution is called sodium extract. This is how I have mentioned how to prepare sodium extract diagrammatically. So first of all, you are taking fusion tube, inserting sodium metal, heating on burner, melting that sodium, introducing organic compound. Again, you are heating slowly first, then strongly on the burner till that fusion tube converts into red hot state. Then you have to pour this into a distilled water, cover that porcelain dish immediately. After that, you have to boil this, you have to reduce the water amount for the to make it concentrated solution. After that, you have to filter it. So whatever filtrate you get, that filtrate is called sodium extract. The quality of sodium extract, you can observe, it should be clear. It should not be colored. So this fusion extract is used for the detection of nitrogen, sulfur, halogen separately. Now, we are going to discuss the chemistry behind the test of nitrogen, sulfur, yucks. What happens when we do this, when we prepare this sodium extract, which chemicals are there in this sodium extract, everything. That means the chemistry behind this practical we are going to discuss now. Now see, now I am discussing second part of this practical. You see, preparation of sodium extract. Whenever you, when you prepare that sodium extract carefully, you get a colorless solution. So if compound is always having this carbon, now you can see the carbon is already there, hydrogen is already there, oxygen might be there. But three crucial elements, nitrogen, sulfur, halogens, if they are present in the organic compound after fusion, when we prepare sodium extract, they are converted. That means if nitrogen is there, nitrogen is converted into sodium cyanide, sulfur is converted to sodium sulfide, and halogen, if it is there, is converted to sodium halide. So we get these three compounds. So what in sodium extract, in fact, either sodium cyanide is there, or sodium sulfide is there, or sodium halide is there, or maybe all these three compounds present in the sodium extract. Now we'll discuss how to perform a test for nitrogen, how to detect nitrogen. It is color test. Now, see, first of all, you have to add FeSO4 solution that you have to prepare freshly into a sodium extract. So this 6NaCl is nothing but the sodium extract. Take 1 or 2 ml of sodium extract, add freshly prepared FeSO4 solution, right? So once you mix these two solutions together, then you get this sodium ferrocyanide, Na4FeCN/6. So this is important. So you get your sodium ferrocyanide. Into this sodium ferrocyanide, actually, once you mix this ferrous sulfate, FeSO4, into this sodium extract, you get this sodium ferrocyanide. After that, if you see, you have to heat that test tube where you are performing this experiment strongly, because this Fe, whenever you heat this Fe dye positive,
from FeSO4 converted to Fe tripositive. So this conversion, this oxidation
is actually taking place when you heat it. Now, after that, when you acidify this, precipitate by using H2SO4,
it is converted to ferric ferrocyanide. So this compound is produced. Ferric ferrocyanide is having color. It's a blue color, or sometimes it looks like green, or it is a mixture of green and blue, pearly and blue color. You can observe here.
So this compound, if you observe during this test, if you observe this blue color or green color or the mixture of blue and green, then it is confirmed that the given organic compound having nitrogen.
So this is a positive test for nitrogen.
What you are doing? You are just using FeSO4. So sometimes
you have to add, instead of FeSO4, along with this, you have to add UPCl3. Even you can use FeCl3.
You can add, after addition of this, you can add FeCl3. So even if
after the addition of FeCl3, that means
you are adding ferric iron. So this ferric ions are actually required to form this complex, which is blue in color or green in color, or the mixture of blue and green. So I think whatever video I have shared,
in that video ferric chloride is used. So you can use it, but the purpose is what? We need that ferric ion.
This Fe tripositive ion is required to form this complex. This is ferric ferrocyanide. Listen, this is sodium ferrocyanide, but this is ferric ferrocyanide. This ferric ferrocyanide complex is blue or green in color. Sometimes it is a mixture of blue and green. So once you get that color test, once you get this positive color test, we call that the compound is having, given organic compound having nitrogen. So this is for the nitrogen. Now I'm moving toward the test for sulfur. Now see, for sulfur test, you are taking this sodium extract, 1 to 2 ml. And if sulfur is present, obviously this will form sodium sulfide. Now, you have to acidify this sodium sulfide with acetic acid. So once you add that acetic acid, you get this H2S, hydrogen sulfide. This hydrogen sulfide is now reacting with lead acetate. So you have to add lead acetate for the sulfur. And once this H2S reacting with lead acid, you get precipitate, black precipitate of lead sulfide. So this is what black precipitate, black PPT you get here. Once you get it, once you observe that your test is positive for the sulfur. So for positive test of sulfur, you must get this black precipitate. Even instead of using this lead acetate, you have one more test. So this is one test, this is another test. During this test, you are using sodium nitroprusside solution. So when you add sodium nitroprusside in a sodium sulfide, in a sodium extract, this is sodium extract. So you get here a red colored solution of this sodium and this complex. Now, this red color solution, if you observe, sometimes it is not exactly red, sometimes it observes pinkish. When you observe this red color solution, it is confirmed that the sulfur is present. So you have two tests. One is a lead acetate test and another is sodium nitroprusside used for the detection of sulfur. Now I'm coming toward the test of halogen. Very simple test. Acidify your sodium extract. Sodium extract means sodium halide here. Acidify your sodium extract, 1 to 2 ml, with nitric acid. After that, you add 2-3 drops of silver nitrate. It's a colorless solution. So when you add it, you get a precipitate. So merely watching the color of this precipitate, you can decide which halogen is there. So if you get white precipitate, halogen is Cl, because AgCl is white in color. When you get AgBr, it's brown or yellowish color.
yellowish color actually. So if you get here yellow color precipitate, it is Br, bromine. And if you get dark yellow or brown color precipitate, then I is present, iodine is present. So merely watching the color of this silver halide, you can decide the halogen present in the molecule. Now another test, sometimes what happens, this if sulfur is there and even nitrogen is also there in the same compound. So in that, I have shown here during the fusion test, if sulfur and nitrogen both elements are there, then we get this sodium sulfur silane. So your sodium extract is how having now sodium sulfur silane. Even you can add that NaCNS. So this NaCNS might be there. So to detect this sodium sulfur cyanide, you are going to add ferric chloride. So when you add ferric chloride, you get a blood red color of this complex, this ferric sulfur cyanide. So this ferric sulfur, this complex is having blood red color. So when you observe blood red color, it is confirmed that the compound is having both nitrogen and sulfur. Now everything is done. We have seen how to prepare sodium extract. We have seen how to perform individual test for nitrogen, sulfur, halogen, and combined test for nitrogen and sulfur. Then the question is, what is the purpose of this? What is the purpose of this experiment? Why we perform this? What is use of this practice? You know, by using this elemental analysis of organic compound, once you come to know that the nitrogen is there, sulfur is there, halogen is there, it is easy to find out, at least guess, which functional group should be there. Say for example, you got positive test for nitrogen. So there is, you know, there are a lot of functional group we have seen in the in theory. Now if you get a positive test for nitrogen, you will find that the nitrogen containing functional group must be there in the organic compound. Now your detection is becoming more perfect. Otherwise, suppose there are 25 tests given for the different functional group, so you have to perform all 25 tests. But if you perform this elemental analysis and if you get positive test for nitrogen, you will sort out only those functional group which are having nitrogen. So you have to perform only 3 to 4 tests to detect the functional group present in the molecule. So similarly, if sulfur is present in your organic compound, you will find the sulfur containing functional group. So you need not to perform all 25 tests. You need to perform 1 to 2 tests if sulfur is there. If halogen is there, it's okay. You will conclude that the halogen is present. So chlorine, bromine, iodine, this halogen is there. So the purpose is, the purpose of this practical is to find the functional group present in the organic compound. We perform elemental analysis. I hope you understood. Thank you.